Welcome into Phil's Tax Hacks and Other Retirement Facts with CPA and personal financial specialist, Phil Putney. Now let's get rolling with today's show. Hey everybody, welcome into this edition of Phil's Tax Hacks and Other Retirement Facts. Thanks for hanging out with Phil and I. This week on the podcast, we're going to talk about why you should never assume, and of course, you know, we're not governed by the FCC if we were on the radio, Phil, so we could probably just say it if we want to. But yeah,
that's right. That old adage
of you and me, if you make the assumptions. So I got a couple of bullet points here. I'm going to go through these with you and just tell me what you've seen in your many years of doing this as to why people make assumptions. And we all do it, right? I mean, all walks of life, we make assumptions about things. It's part of, I think, being human. Right.
Yeah, you know, there's a lot of rules of thumb out there and things like that too. Yeah. Assumptions are typical.
So. Yeah, I mean, it's just part of, you know, ingrained in us as humans. We just assume things sometimes. Sure. But we're going to do this obviously from a retirement standpoint or from a financial planning standpoint. And really, we'll focus mostly, Phil, on the retirement side, I think, more than just, you know, just the investing side. But let's just kick it off with the main one is that we'll spend less money in retirement. Like you and I have talked about this many times. My dad, he passed away young. He did get to retirement, but he wasn't there for very long. And I do remember the one thing he told me pretty early on was he was like, I kind of enjoying it, but every day is a Saturday and I always spend the most money on a Saturday.
That's right. So, yeah. I mean, you're on vacation basically, you know, it's kind of permanent vacation. So what are you going to do with all the time?
And that assumption is we're going to spend less, and that's just not often the case.
Yeah. And that, I mean, it's spending is always an interesting topic to get into, you know, retirement or otherwise, just because number one, we all underestimate what we spend. I mean, it doesn't matter. We've got an interesting, exercise we have clients go through when we're going through the Social Security class or taxes and retirement. Right. You know, we've got a retirement budget worksheet. You know, they go through and fill out, well, this is what we're spending in the different categories. And I have yet to have a client that actually comes up with a real accurate number of this is what we're spending, just because we don't know. You know, it's you don't track it that often. People hate that old, you know, the B word, the budget. Right. So, but yeah, it's but it changes everything, right? I mean, if you underestimate that, it's a bad day in retirement all of a sudden, because you might be way overspending what you could. Mm-hmm. And now all of a sudden that retirement plan doesn't look really good. So,
well, think about this. So you're talking about a budget, for example, you know, when we got a young family, right? When we first got married and we've got our kids and their young kids, we're probably on a more restrictive budget. We're probably watching the household things. You know, we got to buy school clothes and all that kind of stuff and food. But when we're talking about pre-retirees and moving into retirement, before we even get to retirement, you're probably making the most money you've ever made.
Right.
And a lot of that, you start to spend a little bit more without even realizing it. You know, now, if you're really a diligent saver and you're really focused on retirement, maybe you are, you know, kind of watching your budget. But for the most part, like I think about my wife and I, I'm 50 this year, for example. And, you know, I'm like, man, when did I spend that much money on Amazon this month? Or whatever.
Right? Yeah, I mean, as you talk about Amazon, I saw a funny little cartoon the other day that had, you know, a picture of a an ice cream truck on the top and an Amazon truck on the bottom. And it said something to the nature of, you know, things don't change as you get older, just the truck or something like that.
Oh,
you know?
I got you. Yeah. You go from as a kid, running after the ice cream truck to running after the Amazon truck.
Yeah, now we're all excited. Oh, Amazon's here.
That's
but yeah, I mean, it's, you know, you don't, you just don't realize where the money goes. And
yeah.
You know, and underestimate it like that. I mean, my recommendation always, when we're going through that whole spending discussion is, well, let's take a look at a tax return.
Okay.
You know, what income did you bring in? Well, you know, this is what you had to spend. Here's the money that went to taxes.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. You saved money in, you know, specific accounts. I mean, if it's to the 401k or IRA, that's already been taken out.
Right.
Okay. This is what's left. You know, you had 80,000 a year to spend or 90, whatever it is.
Right.
And they're like, well, there's no way I spent that much. Well, I mean, there's only two places it goes. You spend it or you save it. And if it's not in the bank or an investment, you spend it.
That's where it's at. Okay. And don't just assume, again, to the point of the topic this week on the show, that you'll spend less in retirement. Often it's just not the case. Another one, same thing, is the taxes will be lower in retirement. Now, we've beat this, you know, horse a little bit, but we're going to continue because it's really, I mean, taxes is just a huge piece, Phil, of the retirement planning process.
Yes, absolutely.
It just kicks it up even more, how you're setting up your buckets for the different types of, you know, when you're going to take these things out and so on and so forth. And let's be honest, taxes are going to have to go up. And, you know, everybody said that until they're blue in the face. It will happen. Are you prepared for it?
Right. And just even if it doesn't, you know, just understanding taxes and are you really going to be in a lower bracket in retirement? It kind of ties back into that whole concept of spending.
Right.
You know, one of the reasons people assume they're going to be in a lower bracket, well, I'm going to spend less. So I'm going to have less income.
True.
And to some extent, maybe, but yet you still have to understand, well, where is that income coming from? Mm-hmm. And there's pieces of it. If you don't put some controls around it, you've lost control. IRA money, right. You know, you started talking about the buckets. So the more money you have in that middle bucket, that deferred tax bucket, I mean, there might reach a point that you have now all of a sudden more required distributions coming in than you really need to spend. But that's a great problem to have from an sure. income standpoint, but from a tax standpoint, it creates a lot of havoc because of how things work together. You know, I mean, you right. have Social Security, you've got the IRA type monies. If you got a pension, I mean, once all these things kick in, they start to be this compounding effect that the more incomes you have now, Social Security, which is partially taxable, becomes even more taxable.
Right. Yep.
You know, and that's not even talking about the potential for taxes raising, which that's a whole nother discussion.
Right. And again, I think we're kidding ourselves if we think that there's a chance that it's not going to. It's just a matter of when, you know.
Right.
And so if you think about the Social Security aspect, the entitlement programs, you know, I think it's around 75% or so of the financial budget or the government budget goes to entitlement programs. And
right.
everything that's happened with COVID and all this other stuff we're seeing that the new administration's doing, you know, in 10 years, that could easily be 90-95%. And that's not really a stretch because
right.
some of the statistics that I saw on this basically did not factor in the stimulus packages. So,
oh, no. And I mean, it's, you know, they've got the credit card out spending like crazy.
Right.
That's got to be paid, which is a whole nother piece of this equation that that we haven't even started to factor in. And that's interest. You know, I mean, we've grown this massive national debt and we're at one of the lowest points of interest points in history. Right.
Right. Yeah.
So we've grown this massive debt. If interest rates are, I shouldn't say if, when they start to rise, you know, how much of that overall spending budget from the government standpoint that
right.
they have is going to start going towards interest.
Very
you know,
true.
So I mean, it's, there's all sorts of factors in there that, I think you're kidding yourself if you don't think taxes are going to at some point have to go up. I mean, it's just it's math.
And it's fast. It gets away from you a lot quicker than you realize.
Right.
You know, you go, okay, it's, you know, supposedly 400,000 is the threshold. They're going to limit, you know, they're going to raise it or whatever. You'd be just be surprised. And that could easily get tweaked. And if you really take a look at, you know, what the average couple is making, especially as they're getting close to retirement, you're making more than you probably realize. Again, to your point, look at the tax returns, right? So that's another way to take a look at that. And so when we're talking about not making assumptions, again, these are some classic ones that we walk into. And the other one that kind of factors into it, we were talking about entitlement programs. Well, let's go one step further and talk about our own kids and maybe the entitlement that our children feel or that we even feel like we owe them of paying for their college. You know, so you assume that, you know, it's something that you just have to do.
Right.
And we all love our kids. We all want to do the best thing we can for them. But you've got to be really careful, Phil. There becomes a window and a time frame where if you're sacrificing your retirement to help them through college, you may be putting more pressure on them later because now they're going to need, you're going to have to lean on your kids basically in retirement because you can't afford your own.
Right.
So there's
absolutely and it's, you know, again, it's like anything else. I mean, it might be a want or a desire, you know, that you'd like to do that. Great. Let's see if it works. And as long as you go in with your eyes wide open, understanding that if I do that, either I'm going to have to maybe delay retirement or maybe I've got to change my expectations for retirement, you know, and lessen what my budget is, if you want to think of it that way, what I can spend in retirement, you know. I mean, it's just one of those pieces. It's great, I think, to help the kids out because college is so expensive.
It's out of control. Yeah.
That they need some help, but yet you've got to balance that out with your own retirement. And unfortunately, you know, nothing right or wrong about America versus other nations and nationalities and kind of their approach. But, you know, I don't think we have in America that approach where we're going to sacrifice and pay for the kids and get into school and they're going to take care of us in our retirement. That's not typical here, where it is a lot of other nationalities. That's
other countries. There actually is a lot to caring for the elderly. And it is something that we, you know, we don't do as much here from a national focus.
Correct. Yeah. I mean, I've got a couple of clients that are not U.S. born and raised, and their family is in another country. And, you know, they sacrificed to get their kids through school and their doctors now. And part of their budget now is sending money back to mom and dad.
Right.
Because they are effectively mom and dad's retirement plan.
Exactly. You
know? So, and I mean, that's.
We're seeing that more. We're seeing that happen. We've seen that through the financial crisis of 08, 09 started causing issues with that. You know, obviously, you know, COVID, so on and so forth. But it's really easy to. And you, because so many Americans also have been having kids later in life. So a lot of times you think, well, I'm helping my grandkids through college. What is this, you know, helping the kids?
Kids, there's many
Americans who are their kids aren't going to college until they're in their mid or even late 40s. And so you're, you know, when you should be like, you know, 50 and over, when you should be really now starting to sock away more or starting to really plan for your retirement, you're actually still helping your kids in a number of factors, or maybe, and maybe they're not finding a job, or maybe that degree is not, you know, turning out to be as what they thought it was going to be. And they're back living at home with you. And next thing you know, they're trying to get married and have their own life. And now you've got to lean on them because, you know, you're no longer able to do the workforce. And it just becomes a cycle that you got to be real, real careful of.
Yeah. Well, and I mean, it goes way beyond just even physically paying for it. Then you've got to be careful with like Parent PLUS loans. You know, you're taking on a loan yourself thinking you're going to help them. And maybe the agreement was that, once you get the job, you can start paying for it. But at the end of the day, it's your loan. You know, so what happens, you were saying, what if they didn't end up getting the job they wanted or you know, need to be able to pay all this debt back.
Yep.
Now you're personally strapped with a huge amount of debt. So you've got to, I mean, it's one of those things you've got to know both sides of it, right? You know, we talked about assumption. Don't just assume, go in and know the facts, run the numbers to see if I do this, this is the reality. And then have that discussion.
Yep. And these are awesome. They're the most classic places for people that make assumptions when it comes to retirement conversations. And then this final one, Phil, is the classic, I'll just never be able to. Again, why are you making that assumption? So for this one, a bit more of a positive spin is that so many people assume that they cannot retire and they never bother to find out if it's true or not. And so if you don't take the time to sit down with an advisor, run the numbers, pull a plan together, you may not know. And often, the numbers actually support it the other way. Many people come in to an advisor for the first time and say, I'm never going to be able to retire. I just know it. And then they're pleasantly surprised to find out they're in pretty good shape.
Yeah. I mean, this is my favorite discussion. And it happens like you know, I say more often than not where you meet with a client and they're thinking, oh, you know, I think maybe 4 or 5 years down the road and I don't, you know, so you start to run the numbers and you come back and say, yeah, it'll work. And, you know, in fact, if you want, you could probably retire right now. Like, you know, this is what it would look like. And but that's a great discussion to have because it's a burden that a lot of clients have, you know, maybe been carrying thinking, I can't do it. There's no way it's going to work.
Yeah.
You know, or retirement gets forced upon them, which we've seen, you know, unfortunately too often during this pandemic where companies have restructured workforces and downsizing and maybe you're out of a position.
Right.
You know? It's a pleasant surprise to have, the other discussion of, you know, that rose colored glasses client that thinks, oh, this is going to be great. I'm going to spend $100,000 in retirement. And
you
know, I only have 200 in the bank. So
exactly. So just don't make the assumption, folks, because, you know, you make a, you know what, out of you and me. So don't bother to go that route. Have the conversations, find out for sure, you know, where you stand in retirement. And it's just not that hard to do. And often it's just not as painful of a process as we think it's going to be, you know, Phil, people all the time, they finally do it. You know, I hate to do that to you guys, but it's a lot of times people think about it like going to the dentist.
Right. Yep.
You know, it's
never an easy discussion.
It's always going to be bad news, you know, and it's just not. It's not always the case. But even if it is, wouldn't you rather know sooner so you can start the process of getting it fixed?
Right.
Because the sooner you get on the problem, quicker you're going to get there.
Yeah, the more time is on your side. I mean, the quicker you start to analyze and understand and put that timeline together, right, you have time to make some changes. I mean, yeah, if you wait too late and you're out of time, either at your own choice or maybe not, maybe because of health, maybe because right, you know, position's been eliminated or whatever it is.
Right.
Now it's a different story, you know? So if yeah, you've got at least a base plan and understanding up front, if something happens or when it happens, you're better prepared to handle it.
Exactly. So, well, the best time to always start, if you haven't yet, is now. So, you know, yep, if you're watching the podcast or you're listening to the podcast or whatever the case is, and you haven't taken some action, take some action. Reach out to Phil, 248-888-7530, 248-888-7530. If you're watching on YouTube or on the website, philstaxhacks.com, you can just click on the like button. You can just reach out to Phil that way on the page there. There's plenty of information on how to get in contact with Phil on the right-hand side of the page on philstaxhacks.com. Again, philstaxhacks.com. That's the website. You can find us on Apple, Google, Spotify, iHeart, Stitcher, YouTube, all those different places. So subscribe to the podcast. That way you get new episodes as they come out. And we try to keep, you know, this in general, just kind of fun and easy to listen to, some bite-sized 15 minutes or so, just to share some thoughts with you on, you know, this various different topics as to what you might want to consider when it comes to retirement. So again, if you got questions, always check with a qualified professional. Phil's a CPA and a personal financial specialist at AFS Wealth Management at 248-888-7530. And Phil, my friend, that's going to do it this week. Thanks for hanging out with me for a few minutes. I hope you have a great week.
You too.
We'll see you next time here on Phil's Tax Hacks and Other Retirement Facts with Phil Putney. Catch you later.
Investment advisory services offered through AFS Wealth Management. The content of this program is provided for informational purposes only and is not a solicitation or recommendation of any investment strategy. Investments and/or investment strategies involve risk, including the possible loss of principal. There is no assurance that any investment strategy will achieve its objectives.